We do, for the general public, it's like school groups and Cub Scout groups and stuff like that. They come here and it's $5 a kid and it's a 1 hour show that's all custom. We don't do like standard canned performances. They're all different and it's tailored to that group. Like if you're a teacher, you call me up on the first of the month or whatever and say, I've got 50 kids and they're in the eighth grade and we're doing electricity and magnetism. And then you send us a copy of your textbook. And we take that chapter of your book and we write a 1 hour demonstration that ties in with your textbook. And then you come in and we do an hour show on all the stuff that you're covering. That way it's like when you were a kid, you went to the museum for a field trip and it was a screw off day. You might learn a couple things, but it was primarily just we're going to go and it's educational, but we're screwing off. Whereas if you come here for a field trip, it's far more fun and exciting than a museum because I mean we're making lightning and you know explosions and all that, but it ties in. It makes sense. It's stuff that you have a little bit of a background in and you're going to get a lot more hands-on in, and that's what makes us really different from anybody else. And we do this for $5 a kid, so it's cheap. On top of that, that's our public side. We also do a lot of stuff with sponsors, which is still kind of public, but kind of members, where we have, let's say you own a company that makes widgets, and you can send us a bunch of your widgets, and we'll play with them and experiment with them and use them in ways that you never dreamed of, and then we interact with you saying, well, here's how you can make this better, or here's how your product sucks and how you can fix it. It's not, we're not consumer reports. It's not our job to say this sucks or this is great. It's our job to say, okay, this is what it is, and here's what you can do with it, and here's how you can make it better. And if you make something like a tool, or let's say you make milling machines is a good example. You donate a milling machine to us because we need a milling machine. Well, you do it because A, you get publicity, B, you get a big fat tax write-off, C, there's the opportunity for us to create a whole series of educational videos around your product. And say, you know, you've got a milling machine. Well, it's our job to teach people how to use milling machines. So we'll use your milling machine to make 100 videos of how to use a milling machine. And then you can have a copy of those videos. We'll give you the raw footage. And you can use that for whatever you want. If you want to use it for marketing or promotion or education or whatever you want, they're yours. We don't get royalties. We don't want licenses. It's here's the video. Here's $500,000 worth of video production free for a $20,000 milling machine. So we both win because we have the toys to play with and the tools to build stuff, and the sponsors get their name out there and they get promotion and they sell more milling machines. So it's cool. The other side is pure membership. We have guys, lots of guys, all over the country, all over the world. We have members in like 20 other countries, 20, 30 other countries, all 50 states, that you go to the website, you go to www.thegeekgroup.org, and you fill out a membership application. There's a thing right on there that says click here to be a member. And you fill out a basic thing of who you are and what you do and how you heard about us. And you get into forums. You don't have to actually be here to get involved. You can be online and we have a massive archives of just images, videos, technical stuff, you know, books, documentation, all of our projects, all that stuff is going on a website. And it's a community. The idea behind the Geek Group is kind of like herding cats. We're a collection of nerds. We're geeks. You can be black, white, gay, Jew, whatever you want. Every type of person out there somewhere has a peer group, unless you're a geek. Geeks are antisocial. They don't play well with others. Okay? The problem is with geeks is you've got two guys that are both brilliant individuals, but all they get to look forward to is getting beat up at homecoming. So you can come to you can live in the same town, you can live three blocks apart and never meet each other. But you're both doing the same stuff. You both need a soldering iron. You both need screwdrivers. You both need basic tools and materials. And you both have the same problem of not having enough room to do anything because you're doing it in your mom's basement. So our idea is to say, hey, we're this big organization and we're here to have all these toys and to share them. And you can come here and have a soldering iron. And it's the same as like with the Kalamazoo Linux Users Group. That's why they're housed here now. That's why Lugnuts moved here. Because we're a collection of guys like them, and you can come here and you don't have to pay rent. And you have all the space you need and all the tools and all the materials, and it's a peer group. You have other guys that get into the same really weird stuff that you get into. That's why you joined the Linux Users Group, is you wanted to learn about Linux, and you wanted to get into this, but there's a lot to it, and maybe these guys can help. And now you have a peer group, and you make a couple friends. And we've had people come into the Geek Group and meet their future spouse. We've had several members end up getting married. And because it's social networking. This is a place to meet people that think math is cool, that get off on physics, that like to pick up a wrench and build something and do something. And that's the idea, is we want those people, and it's my job to build the passion for them and say, look what we can do together. Because you're a smart guy, and he's a smart guy. And if I put you two together and give you lots of tools and supplies, we can do really cool stuff that on your own you could never do. And it's not because you're not smart enough or you don't have the passion. You've got that. You just need the parts and a place. And that's what I do. I give you the place. It's my job to have the hundreds of thousands of dollars in funding to get a building and materials and tools and supplies and floor epoxy and light bulbs and heat and all that jazz. And all I want is your time. I don't want your money. I don't want you. Membership's free. It always has been. It costs nothing. You get on the internet, you fill out a membership application. I don't want anything. I want your time. I want you to come down here and do what you want to do anyway. I mean, how cool is that? So that's the basics of it. It's the greatest thing ever. The idea here is it's education without having all the overhead of being an accredited degree-granting institution. People don't come here for a degree. You go to college for a degree. People come here for an education. People come here, they walk in the door because I want to learn about Tesla coils. I want to learn about robots or lasers or cars or something. They walk here, they come here because they want to know. People go to college because they want a job. College is a four-year party with a $30,000 cover charge. People come here to get an education. You go to, how many, okay, you went to college. How many people were in college with you that had no desire to be there? They're bored out of their mind. They go there because you have to get that piece of paper. You gotta have that piece of paper. You're not worth anything. This piece of paper is your life. It's a career. It's how you're gonna go make, you know, you're gonna get that liberal arts degree so you can flip burgers. You know, it got a degree in liberal arts. I'm set for a life in food service. You know, no. People come here because they're sitting at home and they want to learn how to program in the KUKA robotics language. Well, you can't go anywhere and learn how to do that without spending thousands of dollars. And there are several organizations that are happy to take your money. And if you just have more money than you know what to do with, by all means, donate. We're broke. This place costs $20,000 a month just to do nothing. So, you know, donations are always appreciated, but you don't have to. And if you want to come down and push a broom and help out and paint a wall and run some conduit or help fix the computers, you're welcome to. We all do. And we've got 16-year-old kids down here working their hearts out till midnight all the time. But we've also got crusty old farts that are 80 years old that come down here on the weekends because their wives are making them nuts. And they just want to spin a wrench. And that's the idea. It's the escape. It's the peer group. It's like a bar for geeks without liquor. So that's what we do.